Hi everyone. Hi guys. Good evening. Good evening. How are you?
Good evening. Good evening, teacher.
Hi everyone. How are you?
How are teacher. You, good evening.
Good evening,
everybody.
Hi. Hey, Berito, good evening, Milagro. Doris, hello. Andres, I like your shirt. I like your Batman shirt.
Yeah.
Very nice. Yeah,
Miss Batman. Pero shh.
I know. Good evening, sir. Milagro, hello.
Hola, teacher, hello.
Happy Children's Day.
Hi, Ada, hello. Elizabeth, good evening. How are you guys? ¿Cómo fue su día? How was it? Was it good? ¿Les fue bien? Everything good?
Fine, very good.
Fine.
Nice. Almost hot.
Terminamos. Almost?
Hot, caliente, con calor.
Like, yeah, I know. Pero creo que es el clima, right? I think it's the weather. It's super, super hot this day. Pero porque está lloviendo también, like, super, like, heavy, you know? But anyways, es parte de nuestro clima tropical. So thank you, everybody, yeah, for joining today's class. Super nice to have you today. Today we have class number 8. Así que ya se nos va el tiempo como corriendo, you know. The time is flying here. And it's so important to have you to have you right here in classes. Y ver que todavía están como bien emocionados, you know, very motivated to continue. This is super important. Guys, me van a disculpar si se me corta la conexión, but creería que es like la lluvia and everything is affecting a lot. So today is October the 1st. Congratulations on Children's Day. Todos llevamos el niño adentro, la niña adentro, you know. Mm-hmm. And it's important. So if you have babies also, it's a very important day for your kids.
Always.
Yes.
Happy Kids Day.
It is Children's Day, right? Oh my goodness, today is not session 6, it's session 8. This is my mistake. Okay, what are we going to... Okay, first, let's remember. ¿Qué se recuerdan de ayer? ¿Qué vimos yesterday? What did we check yesterday? ¿De qué se recuerdan? ¿Alguna
practice
palabra que hayan aprendido?
Conversation, the boss and the garden. yeah.
¿Cómo fue?
The ordens and...
Orders, ajá.
Nuestro chiste de ayer era...
Los Ángeles de Charlie.
Good morning, Charlie. Uh-huh.
I know. Y Ada, de hecho, Ada se quedó esperando también. Ada was waiting que todos le dijeran hi. Uh-huh. Okay. Permítame un segundo, veo que alguien...
Y esto que estuvimos viendo ayer, ¿cómo se llaman?
Lo de ayer se
las
llama...
Las recomendaciones.
Instrucción and orden.
Son imperativos, Milagro. They are imperatives or commands. Para instrucciones, exactly. Milagro, veo que le está dando problema, pero ya alguien se puso en contacto con usted, ¿verdad?
No, ya pude entrar. No podía.
Ah, vaya.
Sí,
nice.
Sí, es que estaba de mal educada la computadora, pero ya estoy.
Ah, ok. I'm happy to hear that. Igual si tiene problemas, no duden en escribirnos y el grupo de soporte rapidito. Ay, acabo de fijar que rapidito le contestaron. So están bien pendientes de ustedes, all right. Isaac, hi Isaac, nice to see you today. Super good to have you. Christian, good evening. Fatima, hello. Madeline, hi there. Edith, also, hello, good evening. Silvia, good evening. Se acaban de conectar, I believe. Pero it's super nice to have you guys. What are we going to check today? What is the agenda for today? Vamos a estar revisando have to, need to. Es para instrucciones, pero es más para necesidades, right? Y obligaciones. So we change the topic a little bit. Then vamos a revisar a little bit of wrap-up, homework. Vamos a tener como, well, siempre tenemos una tareita por ahí. Y les voy a explicar la parte de discussion, ya que ayer me mencionaban algo. Estaba revisando las discussion y veo que todavía algunos me faltan que me participen. So les voy a mostrar, si no lo han encontrado, dónde encontrarla as well. All right, at the end of the class. And this is going to be what we are going to be talking today about. First, tenemos here like a little conversation. Let me read it for you and then you can help me read it. It says, listen to your teacher, read the conversation, and then practice with a partner. So we have Mark Embry. Mark says, I really need that memo, Bri. And Bri says, just a moment, please. Yeah. Mark then says, I need to speak no to Mr.
No se lo escucha bien.
Sorry. Give me a second. Yo creo que es el internet, Milagro. But give me a quick second. Déjeme desconectarme from the cell phone.
Está cortado.
Yeah, I think it's my internet. Yeah, sorry about that. Then, ya me voy a conectar. Give me just a second. Me conecto directo. Then we have just a moment, please. I need to speak to Mr. Wilson. It's very important. And then we have right away. So, I need some people help me with the conversation. Cesar, can you please help me? Me ayuda con la parte de Mark, please. Elizabeth, would you like to help me with Bri, please?
I really need memo, Bri.
Just a moment, please.
I need to speak to Mr. Wilson, please. It's very important.
Right away.
Thank you. So the person says, right away, ahorita, inmediatamente, right away. Right away, okay?
Right away.
Now, let's take a look. Expressions of urgency. En la conversación, hay dos palabras que dicen, it's very important, como es muy importante, and I really need. So, expresamos urgencia when we say, it's very important, I really need it. I really need this favor, okay? It's an emergency, so we can express urgency.
Teacher, I have a question. Right away is en este momento, ¿verdad? Y cuando se dice in this moment, ¿cuál es la diferencia?
Que cuando usted dice in this moment, no expresa urgencia. Solamente es para decir. Por ejemplo, at the moment, como en este momento yo tengo clases. At the moment, I have classes. I am having classes. Indica una acción que está sucediendo en este momento, pero no le encuentro urgencia. Si yo le digo, por ejemplo, at the moment, I am reading a book. Sí, me indica tiempo, pero no una urgencia. Pero si usted me dice, por ejemplo, right away, I need this. Usted ve la urgencia, right away es ahorita mismo, inmediatamente, yeah? When you say, oh my goodness, okay. Cesar, no pagó el recibo, you didn't pay the bill, and you say, right away, yeah? So, es como ahorita, lo hago ahorita mismo, es la diferencia. At the moment, es solo un tiempo, pero right away indica urgencia o rapidez o eficacia, right? So, that's the difference.
Okay.
So, let's take a look.
Thanks, teacher.
Oh, you're welcome. You're welcome. Anytime. So, guys, tell me, what are some of the things that you feel are very important for you right now? What are the things that you really, really need? ¿Cuáles son algunas urgencias que tienen? What are the things I really need and it's very important? Les voy a dar 3 minutitos. Escríbanme en su cuaderno una actividad that you say it's very important to pay the bills. It is very important. Pero algo como que tengan urgencia. And I really need, realmente necesito esto. I really need this, okay? I really need to eat, como realmente necesito, me urge, all right? So les voy a dar 3 minutitos, write it on your notebook y ya las compartimos.
Disculpe, teacher. ¿Podría explicarme qué vamos a hacer, por favor?
Sure, Milagro. Solamente vamos a escribir una oración utilizando it's very important y otra oración utilizando I really need con cosas que a usted le urgen en esos momentos. Cosas que realmente, realmente necesita tener o necesita hacer. All right? In my case, for example, ahora es primero de mes. Tengo que hacer todos mis pagos. I really need to pay for electricity.
Ah, okay.
Okay. Okay. Porque se me olvidó pagar el mes anterior. So I really need to pay electricity. I really need to call my mom because she is sick. So expresan urgencia, un poquito de emergencia, right?
Thank you.
Welcome. Mientras trabajamos en esto, esto está en el manual, right? So pueden siempre referirse a su manual. Chicos, les voy a pasar asistencia rapidito. Me ayudan con la cámara, porfa, y siempre diciéndome present para que quede constancia para InstaFort en el video. Permítanme un segundo. Denme un segundito. Ahora es primero. Today is the first. Okay, guys, solamente me ayudan, porfa, diciéndome present. Fátima López.
Present, teacher.
Gracias, Fátima. Guillermo Torres. Guillermo está por acá. Todavía no. Ada Azucena. Por ahí vi a Ada hace unos minutitos. Ada, ¿está por ahí?
Sí, present, teacher.
Yes, thank you. Isaac.
Present. Present.
Nice, Isaac. Thank you so much. Gracias por unirse. We missed you yesterday. Cristian Molina. Cristian estaba por acá. I think I saw him. Sí, por ahí está. Cristian. Ahora sí le escucho. Thank you. I didn't listen to you. Elizabeth también, ¿verdad?
Teacher.
Gracias, Elizabeth. Edith.
Present.
Gracias, Miss. Silvia.
Present.
Thank you, Silvia. Francisco. Creo que por ahí vio Francisco. Thank you so much. Okay, I got Gerson.
Present.
Thank you, Gerson. And Madeline, también, ¿verdad?
Present.
Thank you. Verónica.
Present.
Thank you, Verónica. Doris.
Present, teacher.
Gracias. Milagros.
Present.
Always present. Thank you. Jennifer.
Present.
Thank you, Jennifer. Andrés.
Present, teacher.
Gracias, Andrés. And Cesar.
Present.
Thank you, Cesar. Me falta Sandra Patricia. Sandra, ¿está por ahí?
Present.
Thank you, Sandra. Sandra Patricia. Y me falta Sandra Beatriz. Sandra Beatriz.
Present, teacher. Good night.
Nice. Hello.
Hello.
Almost, guys. Almost. Full house. Solamente me falta Luz. Luz, Luz, Luz. Luz. No, yet. Oh, casi, casi tenemos full house. Me faltan todavía two. Okay, everybody. So, ¿tienen sus ejemplos? Do you have your examples?
Yes.
Yes.
Yes. Good. So tell me, ¿qué necesitan? What is something that you really, really need?
I really need a cup of coffee.
You really need a cup of coffee? Okay.
Yeah.
I really need to learn English.
Nice. Okay.
It's very important to pay my health fee.
Okay, it's really important to stay healthy. Edith?
I really need my mail.
You really need your mail? ¿Como el correo?
My mail. No, de medicina.
Oh, okay. Okay, your medicine.
Yes.
Okay. I really need my medicine. Yes. Anybody else? It's really important.
Send email report the month.
It's really important to send the report.
Yes.
Okay. Thank you. Creo que vi, escuché por ahí a Adam. I'm not sure.
I really need the sleep. I really need the update.
Do you really need to sleep? Ada, how many hours do you sleep, Ada?
4 and 5 hours.
4 or 5 hours. You really need to sleep. Okay, yes. Guys, what do you really need?
I really need your help in this project.
You really need, okay, really some need, help in the project.
I really need,
yes,
to exercise.
Yes, me too.
Me too.
Me too.
I really need a report the sales.
You need, really need a report, okay, a report of sales.
I really need, me too. Uh-huh. I really need to recharge energy of my cell phone.
Oh, to charge, okay, to charge your cell phone, okay. Jennifer, what do you need?
I really need to take vacation.
Everybody.
It's very important, maybe, the vacation.
It's very important, yes, I know. Yes. But it's difficult, to have them. Okay, Isaac, what do you need, Isaac? What is something you really need?
And the vacation.
Vacation. Money. Okay. All right, guys. Madeline, what is something you really need?
I really need to go to the supermarket.
Okay. To get some food.
Yes.
Ah, okay. Nice. So, guys, we express emergency, urgency, this way, by saying something like, I really need, or it's very important. Now, let's take a look at the following exercise we have here. Tenemos have to y tenemos need to. Hay una pequeña diferencia. Have to es como que es obligatorio, all right? Like when you say, I have to, alguien me obliga a mí a hacer algo, okay? Like, for example, nos obligan a usar mascarilla, right? Y no es que yo quiera, es que I have to wear a mask. Es una obligación, okay? Debo de venir temprano. I have to arrive early at work. Porque es como la policy de mi empresa, la policy de que me obliga a hacerlo. Need to need to es algo que usted siente más como la necesidad de hacer, all right? I need to take a shower, I need to maybe be on time, I need to help my coworkers. So usted siente la necesidad, right? Have to, I need to. Negative, tenemos la forma negativa, and this is the opposite. I don't have to, I don't need to. ¿Cuál es la diferencia? I don't have to, no es necesario, it's like, no es necesario que yo haga esto. I don't have to, okay? Like, I don't have to be 1 hour early. No es necesario, okay, que yo esté una hora antes en el trabajo. So, I don't have to, no es necesario que. No lo traduzcamos como no tengo que porque son diferentes, sino como no es necesario que. All right? I don't need to. Yo no necesito hacer esto. I don't need to do something. So everybody, do me a big favor. Hagamos un par de ejemplos. All right? Sobre las cosas que ustedes tienen que hacer, the things you have to do and the things you need to do. So pueden combinarlas. It's fine. Then, also, I don't have to. Lo que, deme un segundito, give me just a second. Se me fue una fleca. So then, you can use something like, I don't have to. No es necesario que yo haga esto. I don't need to. No necesito hacer esto, all right? So, write a couple of examples. Si quieren que se los revise o que les eche una miradita, podemos escribirlos en el chat. Feel the freedom, escríbanlos en el chat y con gusto yo los reviso and I tell you if si los comprendemos, right? If they are clear, I will give you like 3-4 minutes. Think about your company, think about no solo la empresa, sino afuera también, socialmente hablando, like in the street, okay, in your company, in your neighborhood.
Teacher, una question. The have to is no es necesario.
Yes, correcto.
Y don't need to es no necesito.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. Okay. Lo que sucede es que a veces traducimos literal y vemos don't have to, no tengo que, pero eso vamos a confundirnos. Entonces traduzcamos don't have to como yo no necesito o no es necesario que yo haga algo. All right? I don't have to. Like, for example, in my case... Okay. No es necesario que yo llame a todos los participantes todos los días, so I don't have to call you guys porque hay un equipo encargado de eso, because there is a team in charge of that, all right? I don't have to study English 20 hours. I can study English only 2 or 3 hours. No es necesario que yo memorice 1,000 verbos. I don't have to memorize 1,000 verbs. Puedo memorizar 10. I can memorize 10, 20, 30. So, esa es la diferencia. That's the difference.
Okay. Thanks, teacher.
You are welcome.
Teacher.
Yes, Milagro.
How to... ¿Tiene que o tengo que?
Depende con quién usted lo conjugue, Milagro, porque recordemos que este solo es un verbo. Usted puede decir I have to, como yo, o yo le puedo decir, Milagro, you have to. Entonces depende de la conjugación.
Pero si yo digo teacher have to, entonces tienes que.
Ok, sería como, no, creo que me quiere decir como en tercera persona, como la teacher tiene que. Entonces, sí se puede, pero vamos a hacer un pequeño cambio. Si usted se recuerda, estuvimos viendo a las terceras personas y veíamos que cuando usted tiene he, she, etcétera, vamos a hacer un cambio. Entonces, have to, si usted quiere usar tercera persona, vamos a cambiarlo a has to. Need to, vamos a hacer el cambio también y usamos needs to. ¿Ya? So, la regla se mantiene. Las reglas de terceras personas no las vamos a cambiar. Por ejemplo, voy a tomar su ejemplo, Milagro, because I think it's important. The teacher, y quiero decir no de mí ni de usted, sino que de ella, all right? Entonces no puedo usar the teacher have to, porque es tercera persona, right? The teacher has to be on time. Pero uso has to para indicar una obligación, right?
Okay, y si lo quiero usar así, como usted lo ha puesto ahí, have to, ¿cómo sería una oración?
Con todos los que no sean terceras personas. Por ejemplo, I have to be on time. You have to be on time. We have to be on time. They have to be on time. So, remember, el cambio lo hacemos con tres pronombres. Guys, ¿me ayudan?
And he.
We use
he. She.
He. Exactly. So, cuando usted utilice esos pronombres, es que usted dice, for example, Caesar. I come and I say, Caesar, have to. Eso no se puede, ¿ya? Yeah? So, Caesar has to. Okay, I think it's necessary. Caesar has to take a cup of coffee. Okay. So, Caesar has to take a cup of coffee. So, yes. El debe de, el tiene que. Okay. Yeah, so Caesar has to take a cup of coffee. Entonces,
yes, I
seguimos
need to
como
drink
like
every morning.
Yeah. Oh, in the morning.
Every
no,
morning.
I need a tea because I got the flu.
Teacher.
Sandra, yes.
Pero cuando decimos, cuando usamos el don't need to, por ejemplo, si yo voy a decir she doesn't, sería entonces. Mm-hmm.
Correcto, that, yeah.
That's a yes. Soda, okay?
Exactly. Okay. So, de la misma forma, exactly, you're totally right. En vez de decir, I don't have to, pero si yo tengo una tercera persona, entonces hago el cambio, yeah, and I say, she doesn't have to. El verbo no lo cambio acá, right? Lo único que va a cambiar es don't or doesn't. Mm-hmm.
Okay, thank you.
You are welcome. Pregunten, guys, sin pena, ask questions. Si todavía les quedó la duda, go ahead and ask, no problem.
Teacher, en este caso solo es cuando es una acción que necesito hacer, pero si yo digo, I need money,
oh, yeah.
Tú, no entra en estos ejemplos.
Sí, es necesidad. Lo único que no necesito el tú. Ajá, ya no lleva tú. No, it's not necessary. You get a point. Yeah, like you can say, I need money, I need a vacation, I need more friends. So, tú is not necessary. I need food. Oh, pero si es una actividad como eat, entonces sí lo lleva. I need to eat. Ajá, I need to eat.
Okay.
Ahí se lo lleva. So, with verbs, con otros verbos, con right?
Verbs.
Yes, exactly.
Excelente, gracias.
Welcome. So guys, 3 y 3 estaría bien. Let me know when you finish. Let me know if you need more time. Okay. I'll give you one more minute, guys. I'll give you one more minute. Is everybody ready? Do you need more time? Do you need more time, guys? Are you ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, very good, very good. So we are going. Okay, everybody, so listen, vamos a ir al grupo. We are going to go to smaller groups and let's share, vamos a compartir, share with your classmates, okay, all the activities that you need to do, all right, and that you have to do, al igual que las que no necesitan hacer, the ones that are not necessary to do in your place. I'll give you 5 minutes, share, listen to your classmates, y luego regresamos. Si pueden, if it is possible, tomen nota de lo que dice el compañero. He has to, she has to, okay? So let's go ahead. Go ahead, everybody. Let's join the groups.
Teacher.
¿Me escucha, Milagro? Can you listen?
Sí, okay. Es que este tema como que no lo he entendido.
Dígame, ¿qué es lo que se le está dificultando?
No entiendo cómo hacer una oración. I need to, o sea, need to, no sé.
Como mi ejemplo, Milagro, like my example. Ve mi pantalla, can you see here? Sí. Ah, vaya, le comparto. Permítame, voy a hacer eso más pequeño. So, si usted se fija, dice, I have to, I need to. Caesar has to take a cup of coffee. Yo vengo y solamente voy a hablar de las cosas que yo necesito hacer o que yo debo de hacer. Por ejemplo, I have to, yo debo de, I have to take a cup of coffee. This is not an emergency, pero, for example, imagine that I tell you, Milagro, I have a terrible headache. No aguanto el dolor de cabeza. I have a terrible headache. I have fever. I have the cough. Y usted viene y me dice, oh, es obligatorio que vaya al hospital. All right? And you have to tell me that. O yo digo, yo tengo que ir al hospital. I have to. ¿Cómo me diría tengo que ir al hospital? I have to.
To go hospital. Mm-hmm.
Exactly. I have to go to the hospital. Yes. So I feel, I have fever. I have headache. I have the cold. I'm like, choo, choo. So I have to go to the hospital. O lo podemos cambiar y usted me dice, no, teacher, usted debe de ir al hospital. So you can tell me also, you have to go to the hospital. So you have to go to the hospital. Un poco mejor, a little bit better.
Y el otro con el need to es el que tengo más problemas. Yo fíjese que yo en las oraciones puse I have to go to the market. ¿Está bien?
Yes, of course, of course.
I have to wash my car.
Yeah, that's good.
I have to get up early.
Yes, yes, you got it.
Bye. Pero ya para hacer el need to, ahí sí me topé, no, no sé.
Pero Milagro, es lo mismo, es lo mismo. Usted viene y es el cambio. Lo que va a cambiar en realidad es el sentido que usted le ve. I have to son obligaciones que alguien más le impone. Need to son cosas que usted siente la necesidad de hacer. Fíjese en mi pantalla, porfa. Por ejemplo, tiene acá, you have to go to the hospital. Vamos a cambiar, vamos a eliminar estas dos, all right? Y en vez de estas, yo voy a utilizar la otra que es need to. Es, lo único que estoy haciendo es un cambio, ¿ok? Need to. Ahora, léamelas.
Tú necesitas ir al hospital.
¿Okay? Es lo mismo. Solo que la una es usted necesita y la otra es usted tiene que.
Oh.
Pero se escribe, si usted se fija, yo lo puedo cambiar nuevamente y puedo decir, you have to. You have to go. You need to go. Es la misma idea. Yes.
La una es tener que y la otra es necesito.
Exactly.
Necesitar.
Exactly. So, cuando usted le dice a alguien, por ejemplo, necesito que me devuelvas el dinero. I need to get my money. Yo necesito mi dinero. Okay. Pero es la misma idea. I have to, I need to. El significado es el que cambia.
Thank you, teacher.
You're welcome. No problem. Milagro, ¿le aparece la invitación todavía?
Sí, ahorita.
Ah,
voy.
Okay, super ahorita good. Voy.
Sí. Ya pasó septiembre.
Sí, ya.
Todavía, sí, hasta el todavía. Domingo, hasta el domingo.
Todavía aplica.
Are you talking about donuts?
Yes.
Yeah. Two per one.
Who needs to eat donuts? Who needs?
Veronica needs.
Veronica needs donuts.
It's donuts.
Yeah. You know what? Pasó septiembre. September is over, and I didn't eat donuts. So yeah, it's true. I didn't eat donuts. So Veronica,
but in September the donuts is very
small.
Small, and the quality
is bad.
Okay.
Did you eat donuts?
Yes.
Stuffed.
Okay. So only with Caesar, what did you say? Yes.
Stuffed.
Yo escuché estafa, but I was like, what? Stuffed, the stuffy one.
Yeah,
okay.
And you, teacher, do you like the donut?
Not really. I'm not a big fan. I think I prefer more Salvadorian stuff.
Bananas.
I eat donuts, but like once a year. So I don't like it very much, yeah. And this year, se me olvidó, I forgot it. So, Vero, you said Saturday or Sunday? When is the last
Sunday.
Day?
Sunday.
Sunday, okay. Sunday. I will buy donuts then.
Sunday.
Okay, my sentence is, he has to call her... No, him, yes, she has to call her mom.
She has to call her mom.
Sabe.
Ajá, ahorrar, save a money.
I need to practice
speaking English. I need to consume.
Can you repeat the first sentence, please?
I need to save a money a little more.
Okay.
No, la luz.
Just say, you need to save money.
Ya decía por qué me están pidiendo oración.
But Isaac, I didn't listen to the second part. I need to save money to learn more or to learn more. What is your sentence? I need to save money. Necesito ahorrar dinero, right? I need to save money and learn more y aprender más.
No, creo que era necesito ahorrar un poco más.
Ah, okay. So I need to save money. No, it's okay. It's okay. Solo que me quedé con la parte de learn more. Ah, okay. Okay.
First sentence.
Okay.
The first.
I have to work.
First sentence. Isaac, repeat, please.
Ah, the first sentence. I have to get up early every day.
What happened? I'm like, what happened?
Teacher, I have a question.
Yes.
Vaya. Cuando yo digo he needs, por ejemplo, yo estaba escribiendo la oración que dijo Francisco. Él dijo, I need to go to the beach. Como yo necesito ir a la playa.
To the beach.
To the beach. Va. Entonces yo la copié así. He needs. Y ahí tengo la pregunta. Si ya le puse needs, ¿tengo que ponerle to goes o to go?
No, cuando usted tenga un to antes de un verbo, no se cambia. So, he needs to go. Ese go ya no se puede cambiar. ¿Mm?
Ok.
Sí, dice que no.
Hello. Hi, girls. Why are you so quiet? What happened?
Teacher.
Hi.
Por ejemplo, yo puedo poner she have to go to work. Es correcto.
Sí, es correcto. Solo milagro. Repítame la parte del primer verbo, porfa. She
have to.
Solo hagamos el cambio que acabamos de realizar, ¿se recuerda? Tercera persona. She.
Ah, ya. Has.
Ajá, yes.
Has to.
Yes, okay. Yes.
Has to. Ok. Estoy practicando porque no se me olvide.
No, súper bien, súper bien. Pero también escúchense. Es bien importante que usted escuche al compañero porque lo internaliza, right? So listen to your
Y si la quiero hacer negativa. Si la quiero hacer negativa esta, she has to go to court. Si la quiero hacer negativa, She doesn't to.
She doesn't.
No.
Solo cámbiame el orden del tú. She doesn't.
She doesn't.
She doesn't have to. Exactly.
Sandra. She doesn't has to.
Sí, pero ya no me cambié el verbo. She doesn't have to.
Sí, aquí ya
no lo cambiamos.
Ya no cambia el verbo en negativo. Aquí ya sería have to.
Exactly. So, chicas, practiquen a little bit. Háblense, teacher. Say hello. Tell me, Sandra.
Si yo utilizo la tercera persona, voy a cambiarlo a have to y a need to. Pero el verbo sigue, no le agrego la S.
No, no, miss. Usted solamente dice she has to, usted ya lo cambió. Por ejemplo, dígame ahorita qué es lo que su bebé quiere.
Dana needs to candy.
Ah, she needs to eat candies. Yes, candy. Yes, yes, yes. Entonces, she needs to eat candies. Exactly. Or, por ejemplo, she has, no, bueno, she needs to, it's okay. She no, doesn't have
no
to.
No la va a dejar dormir porque no. Quiere dulces, imagínense,
no.
Hasta ahora.
She doesn't, Sandra, she doesn't need candy.
She doesn't.
And chocolate. No, she doesn't need them. Otherwise, you will not sleep.
Entonces, los verbos van a seguir en presente.
Exacto.
Normal.
Exacto.
Solo ya al invertir la tercera persona, suficiente.
Exacto. Cuando usted ya me dice she needs to, she has to, ese es el cambio que usted hace, nada más. Yes.
Okay, thank
okay,
you.
Okay, girls. To each other. Say hello to each other. Déjenme ver cómo van los demás. And I'll give you 1 minute y luego volvemos. 1 minute, guys.
Y da, no, es que me quería referir a todos, donde dice que...
We, they,
ajá, we. We, da, no, pero ahí se dice
we,
we
are.
¿Ah? We don't.
O they.
We, they
we
don't.
Don't. We, en we sería, that? We don't.
Everybody.
Es we don't.
We don't. We don't the need to out the house. Quédate en casa.
Wow.
I really like that one. So, so sería como we don't need to or we don't have to. What do you think? We don't need to?
Obligation. Have to.
Like an obligation, right? Entonces sería más como la de ayer. Stay. Like an imperative, like an order. Stay in your house. Jennifer?
But yes? The other oraciones?
Sentences?
The other sentences, the she, he is going to the beach, need vacation.
You, or she, or he, me. Who?
I don't remember name is Ada.
Oh, Ada. So Ada needs to go to the beach. No, but I believe. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, you have been working a lot. So she needs vacation. That's true.
She needs vacation. She needs to visit the beach and sleep in the arroyo at the sea.
It's more relaxed.
That sounds okay with the sound, with the sound, the sound, with the sound of the sea.
Yeah.
With the sound of the water. Yeah, Sandra.
Dije, y logró usted pudo actualizar mi progreso.
Fíjense, Miss, que lo comenté y todavía estoy pendiente que me confirmen soporte. Pero ahí estamos pendientes, oiga.
Ya leí que no todas las discusiones, ya las hice.
Ay, vaya. Súper bien. Yo se las voy a revisar también, que ahí no he entrado. Ya se las reviso.
Hasta las 6 está, okay. ¿Verdad?
Hasta las 6.
Hasta las
6. Sí, correcto. Hasta las 6. Okay. Yep. Ahora, no estaba la de ahora todavía. Okay, guys. So Ada needs vacation, she needs to sleep, she needs to go to the beach. What about you, Sandra? What do you need?
What do you need? You need to drink water every day.
Okay. And you? What about you?
I need, Sandra. To drink water every day.
Uh-huh. You,
I mean,
I need.
Uh-huh,
yeah, I need.
I mean, your example is okay.
See the question, Sandra.
Your example is good. Cuando usted me dice you need to, it's okay. Lo único que cuando usted me dice you need to, es como que me, no se esté diciendo, right? Ajá. And what about you? Ajá.
Necesita.
Ajá. What do you need?
Ahí es como que Sandra le estaba diciendo que usted necesita. Así se entendió.
Exactly.
Ajá. Pero cuando me preguntando a ella.
Es I don't.
Ajá.
Cuando me refiero a él, es he needs.
He
needs.
Ajá. Needs, con S.
Para he, yes.
Para el verbo, ¿verdad?
Yes, correct. Sandra, but what about you, personally? What do you need? ¿Qué necesita usted? What do you need?
Yes, vacation.
Everybody.
Travel.
Everybody needs to sleep and vacation. And a long vacation. Okay. Anything else? That's it. We don't need too many things.
We in group need actualization that discussion in the platform.
You need to complete the discussion.
Yeah.
And
why not? Porque no sabíamos dónde estaba.
Estábamos
esperando que estuviera de.
No,
de, ¿cómo sería? Abajo del video.
The update. To be honest with you, lo descubrí ayer con Sandra, because I was telling her. lo que sucede es que con el video había que esperar, ¿verdad? Que el video estaba ready. So, ahí está, aparece como tareitas, entonces todos los días hay tareitas. And I was checking and I said, ¿qué pasó con estos chicos? What happened with them? Solo que era la parte que yo asumí, that was my mistake. Asumí que you knew la discusión. But thank you guys, gracias por ayudarme with that part, okay? No problem. Okay, everybody, so regresemos, let's go back to the other meeting. That was very nice. That was very good practice, guys. Thanks everybody for coming back. I think almost everybody is here. Yes, almost everybody is back. All right, thank you very much. I was listening to you guys and no sé si les ha quedado como por ahí alguna pregunta de cómo usar need to, have to. I listened to you guys and that was very good. You got it. Incluso me utilizaron terceras personas, so that was very, very nice. Any question? Any comment on this? Or we got it? None. Okay, very nice. So let's go on. Let's move on to the next activity we have. And this is a little reading that we have for today. So if you take a look, this is in your manual. And this one says reading. Pair work. Read the email and organize the activities Guadalupe needs to do by importance. So this one says, Dear Guadalupe. So first of all, vamos a identificar algunos elementos. ¿Quién está escribiendo? Who is writing the email? Who is sending the email?
Daniel Ruiz.
Daniel Ruiz is writing this email to Guadalupe, right? So le indica cuáles son las actividades that she has to do. But the activity here is this. Organize the activities Guadalupe needs to do by importance. En el email van a ver algunas palabras que indican urgencia. For example, this is very important. This is really necessary. I really need, yeah? So vamos a identificar cuál es urgente, which is like, oh, de estas, esa es la primera. This is super, super important, top priority. Number two, un poquito, you know. Number three, esas pueden esperar. So I will give you 5 minutes. And si encuentran vocabulario nuevo, get it on your notebook, write it down, okay? Y luego lo revisamos. So I'll give you 5 minutes para leerlo y ordenar las actividades in four. The first, the second, the third, and the fourth. One more minute, guys. Okay, everybody, time is over, but I want to know, do you need more time or ya las tiene? Are you finished with the exercise? Do you need 1 minute, 2 minutes, or are you ready?
I finish.
Okay, Cesar, you finish. Okay, thank you, Francisco. Thank you, guys. Okay, very good. So let's start with number four, which is fourth. Which activity do you have in number four?
Contact the first three potential customers.
Oh.
No.
Number four, yes.
This is the tour, the tour story in Santa Tecla.
Santa Tecla. Exactly.
Okay, so some of you said contact the three potential customers, and some of you mentioned Santa Tecla, right? The one that says...
Yeah.
Yes.
Give me a second. My internet is going down. Okay. Okay, so remember, hablamos de like urgencia, like... ¿Cuánto tiempo tengo para hacer algo? How much time do I have to do an activity? So, de estas, from these, ¿para cuáles le dan más tiempo? Because here, for example, dice la primera, you have 3 days. La siguiente dice, you have 2 days. Then,
2 days, 2 hours.
And then, 2 days. So, de estas, ¿cuál es la number four? La última.
3 days.
La que tiene 3 días. So that would be contact the first 3 potential customers from the list because you have 3 days to do it. Tiene 3 días para hacerlo. So es como tiene más tiempo, right? You got 3 days to do it. Now, number three. Tienen en tercer lugar. Which one is in third place? Third place?
Tour in Santa Tecla.
The one for Santa Tecla?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. What about second place? ¿Cuál tienen como segundo? Which is second place?
Call.
And the
new client.
Call the new client.
Call the new clients. Entonces, de estas, ¿cuál es urgente? Which is number one? Which is the priority?
It's very important to send.
I really need
a new welcome letter.
Okay, so si nos fijamos a la que Isaac dice, is this one. It is very important to send the 2 latest sales report on May 26th. And then write a new welcome letter for the new customers. You have 1 day to do it. So it's como solo tiene un día. Solo tiene 1 day to complete activities. So this is exactly the first activity. Very good, everybody. Si tenemos algo similar, so then you're doing just fine. All right. So very, very nice. Now,
teacher, solo una pregunta.
Tell me, Gerson.
Cuando dice 3 hours each day, es 3 horas por día.
Yes, but pretty much, si usted se fija en la última parte, le dice organize your week. I mean, normally en nuestro trabajo no nos dicen cuánto tiempo tenemos, right? Le dicen, escríbame un reporte y lo quiero para mañana. But here, son bien específicos. Here, the person is telling you, okay, so escríbame un reporte y tiene un día. Dedíqueme 3 horas de ese día, you know, to complete this activity. So, es como bien específico, very, very specific. But la prioridad depende del tiempo que le den, right? So, this is what matters here. Okay, guys. So, here it's like the activities they have to do. Now, the next activity is for you to speak a little bit, okay? And this is, like your task of the day. So, the task of the day is make a conversation talking about the activities you need to and you have to do at work. So the idea is to make it at work, pero ustedes lo pueden variar un poquito and you can talk about personal activities also. But things you need to do, you have to do you don't need to do and you don't have to do. So try to put everything together, right? I will give you a like 12 minutes to prepare a short, a brief conversation. I'm going to change the groups so you have the opportunity to talk to other people and prepare one conversation talking, oh, I need to, I have to. Lo mismo que hicimos. And guys, super important. Vamos a intentar hacer esta actividad sin diccionario. We are going to try to do this activity sin Google Translator, sin dictionary. Si necesitan cómo decir una palabra, auxílense del compañero, right? Si no saben cómo decir algo, no se compliquen la vida yendo con palabras muy rebuscadas, muy literales, sino con lo que se recuerde, intentemos hacerla, right? No la vamos a leer, we are not gonna read it. Entonces vamos a intentar hacerlo como muy fluido, practiquémoslo mucho, ok? Practice as much as possible. Si lo pueden escribir, no hay problema, pero la idea es no depender mucho del diccionario, right? Intentemos hacerlo un poquito más independiente every single day. So, let me make the groups. Solo denme un segundito para que queden con personas diferentes, like different people. And then everybody will be participating. So, here we go. Four. Okay, give me one second. Give me one. Give me one. Okay, everybody. So go to your groups, please. Prepare a conversation. Practice as much as you can. Y luego, luego we come back. You get 15 minutes to complete activity. So everybody, let's go. Let's go. Hi guys.
No, mi teacher le di el botón que no era.
Sí, soy. What are you doing? No se preocupe, sí, soy. Deme un segundo. Give me a second. Si no me aparece. Vaya, ahorita lo envío al grupo. Okay, you're welcome.
Thank you.
César pudo entrar.
No me mandó a ninguna parte.
Vaya,
no me apareció el mensaje para entrar.
Vaya, permítame ahorita, se lo envío. Revise, porfa. Quizás no está dando el update.
No me sale.
No le sale. Déjeme ver. Give me just 1 minute. Déjenme ver, creo que no lo puedo agregar directo. No le aparece, sí, sorry. No le está.
No,
le
no, no me aparece. La invitación, no me sale.
Uh-huh. Hágame un enorme, enorme favor. No, yo creo que no se puede actualizar, right? We cannot update it. Déjenme ver, porque a mí sí me parece que está la invitación, pero que no ha entrado.
Y no me aparece la invitación.
Déjenme ver, let me see what we can do here. Thank you. Cesar, ¿y está en la computadora?
Sí, en la computadora estoy.
Donde cuando usted, en la parte superior de su picture, de su imagen, ¿sí? Donde están los tres puntitos, le da alguna opción.
Déjeme ver.
¿Le parece como la opción de entrar a algún grupo de...?
Dice participants, invite, chat, record, join breakup room. Aquí está.
Ese que dice breakup. Uh-huh.
Ah, ya me parece.
Dale clic, porfa. Ah, bye. Ok.
Use safe equipment.
Thank you, Ada.
Okay.
I need to read the word. I need to do the study for 8 hours.
Okay.
Es obligatorio, pues, 8 horas mínimo. The work. I need to the take the report.
Okay.
Captain.
I need to connect English class 8 o'clock.
Yeah. Hi guys. I think it's pretty nice. I was listening to you guys. I think you got it. Just escojamos como un ambiente. Try to think about an environment. Puede ser like your job. Puede ser like a situation outside your job. E intentemos hacerlo como una conversación natural. Like a very natural conversation. Sin fijarnos tanto en la gramática, pero que vaya todo junto, right? Like, if I ask you, for example, Ada, what's wrong with you? What's going on, you know? And then she says, like, oh, no he dormido en, I don't know, 2 meses. I haven't slept in a long time. I really need to sleep today, okay? Entonces, para que sea como más natural, que fluya un poquito, right? And we practice more vocabulary. So... try everybody to interact. Chicos, hay 5 acá. There are... No, solo 4. Yo soy la quinta. Okay, never mind. I was like... No, I made sure. Me aseguré que hubiera solo 3 o 4. And I was like, ¿por qué hay 5? No me conté. Okay, guys. So, go ahead and try to practice it.
Do you need to? Yes, teacher.
Hi, sorry, acabo de venir. Hi. Tell me. So le dije, yeah, teacher, I was like, what?
Es que Cristian estaba respondiendo.
Ajá, yo estaba diciendo como que puedo preguntar, como haciéndoles la pregunta de, what about you? What about you, Veronica? Tell me, what do you need to?
Need
to, quizás necesita algo más. Es demasiado como específico. Y, perdón, pero ¿cuál es el ambiente? What is the situation?
Es como, ¿qué debes hacer? ¿Qué debes hacer? ¿O qué necesitas?
Mm-hmm. Podemos escoger una situación específica, you know. Por ejemplo, podemos hacerlo como en el trabajo, all right?
Ajá, debo hacer esto, también necesito hacer esto.
Iba a decirle Iba que quería comer.
Vaya, por ejemplo, yeah, you can tell. For example, él le puede decir a Christian, hey Christian, do you have a candy?
Pero and you're pregunta, like, pero la pregunta why? Como para hacer énfasis en eso es como...
Lo que sucede es que si me lo deja hasta el tú, me lo deja como cortado. Pero usted le puede preguntar, por ejemplo, Verónica, what do you need? ¿Cómo que necesitas? What do you need? o me la hace completa. Ah, okay, me la hace completa. Verónica, what do you need to complete today? What do you need to do today? What do you need to make today? Mm-hmm. Aunque sería más como el do, quizás. O por ejemplo, imagínese que Verónica es una cocinera, es un chef, y usted le dice, Verónica, ¿qué te falta cocinar? So, what do you need to cook today? Entonces, para que sea la pregunta cabal, completa.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Like, for example, Christian, I know that you work in a company for fixing machines, and I can ask you, hey, Christian, what do you need to do tomorrow? Or what do you need to fix tomorrow? So, bien específico. Mm-hmm. So, we can do that.
Okay, entonces... Okay. What about?
Do you need to complete?
Call to my clients. And I have to, ¿cómo se dice? Entrar. O sea,
¿entrar a trabajar?
Ajá.
Start working.
Okay. Mm. I need to start working at 8 a.m. Okay, Gerson. What is your activities need to do at the work?
I need to check my email. I have to check my email and I have to write the reports, and I need to drink a cup of coffee, and I need to check this bank statement, and I need to supervise the employees, and I need to pay the customers is proveedores, sí.
You can say the customers son los clientes directos. The providers.
Providers.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I need to pay the providers, I think, in your case. Hey, guys, okay. I think you're doing a very nice job. Just remember that need to and have to no solamente es como las obligaciones dentro del trabajo, sino que las usamos en a daily basis. So, podemos crear como una situación en la que todos los cinco, yo me incluyo, en la que todos estén involucrados y usamos need to or have to, right? Like, I was telling these guys, por ejemplo, cuando usted está como bien sad, like you can say, oh, I don't feel well today. I feel really sick, for example. I need to take an acetaminophen because I have a headache. So, si ustedes ponen atención, usamos need to, usamos have to, right? No necesariamente enfocado like en algo bien cerradito, en algo bien lineal, sino que hay muchos ambientes. So, para que todos puedan participar y sea un poco más, you know, interactive, podemos pensar en una situación y que todos podamos aportar a little bit. For example, when I tell my family, I have a backache, todos en mi casa comienzan, oh, you need to rest. You need to sit straight, okay? And they start telling me recommendations. So, pueden usarlo that way, all right? I will give you some minutes, practice, guys, and get ready for this.
Sí, ya se oye fluido. Vaya, otra vez.
Hi, girls. How do you doing in your work?
I'm very tired because I have to organize plan 2021. And you, Doris?
I have to arrange reports and meetings. And you, Marily?
I feel good because I have a new work and I have to arrive early because I need to send memos, emails, and reports.
Hey girl, we need to go to the party on Friday.
Yes, it's a good idea. Y ahí le vamos a cambiar porque estaba así como, ¿dónde es? Y como estamos hablando que el viernes será la fiesta, se puede cambiar a where will it be? Where will it be? Como que, ¿dónde será? Y ahí ya lo hacemos a futuro. Where will it be?
Eso lo diría usted.
Yeah.
Where?
Mm-hmm.
Where it will be.
Where will it be?
Where will it be?
Where is it be?
¿Dónde será?
Mm-hmm.
Con interrogante, ¿verdad?
Sí, cierre nada más.
Pero, y entonces estaría bien que yo diga, it's in my house.
Sí, porque lo que le estoy preguntando es que ¿dónde va a ser?
Ah, va, es en mi casa. Ok, otra vez, vaya.
Bye.
Hi, girls, what do you... Ay, eso me traba. Hi, girls, what do you doing in your work?
I'm very tired because I have to organize plan 2021. And you, Doris?
I have to arrange reports and meetings. And you, Madeline?
I feel good because I have a new work and I have to arrive early because I need to send memos, emails, and reports.
Hey, girl, we need to go to the party on Friday?
Yes, it's a good idea. Where will it be?
It's in my house. See you later.
Okay, bye-bye.
Bye, Madeline.
Listo.
Are you ready, girls?
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes.
Just say ready.
Pero no podemos sin escribir, o sea, tenemos que escribirlo porque todavía no podemos.
No, no se preocupen, amigos, ustedes pueden tomar notas, ¿right? La idea es, entre menos lo lean, más fluidez van a tomar. So that is the idea, to get some fluency. Y empezar a hacerlo como más rapidito, let's say, más fluent, okay. So I will give you like 2 more minutes. Si necesitan, do it one more time. Go ahead, no problem. I'll see you in 2 minutes.
Okay, thank you.
I need send reports, ¿verdad? I need to send reports, dijo, ¿verdad? Email reports, no creo, sino que solo tiene que ser como because I need to send emails or send reports only, but emails, okay. Reports, ajá. Entonces, okay. No sé. Entonces, because I need send...
Report.
Because I need to send reports of the last month. Reports of the last month. Of the last month. Then, que significa luego... Then I have to arrange a meeting with my bosses.
I have to arrange
a meeting with my bosses. Mm-hmm.
What do you do at work, Jennifer?
I need to go to the inspection. I have to check email. I have to go to the meeting.
Y la otra es que le digo yo que más que yo tiene una por ciento de lo que tiene por ciento de lo que tiene por ciento de lo que tiene por
Hey everyone, thank you for coming back. Thank you very much. Thank you so much. I was listening to some of you talking about the things you need to do and the things you have to do. So I really want to listen to your ideas, guys. And it is not necessary to make it very lineal, you know, like solamente enfocado in I have to, but you can vary. Remember that English is used in a different number, okay, of situations. So that is the idea. I am going to. Oh, it's difficult. Guys, me escuchan? Can you listen to me?
Yes.
Okay, so decía que estaba en silencio. All right. So it is a little difficult, all right? To select volunteers. So I really need volunteers. Who wants to volunteer today? Milagro.
Eso, milagro.
Bárbara, milagro.
Es que teacher, you antes de que me sugieran, entonces mejor le entramos de un solo.
Exacto, milagro.
But I like it because that is a very positive attitude, you know, and thank you very much. So everybody, let's start. So that was Milagro. ¿Quién más estaba en tu grupo?
Francisco.
Elizabeth. Okay, perfect. Go ahead, please.
Hi, Milagro. Hi, Elizabeth. How are you?
Hi, Francisco. I'm fine.
Hi, Francisco. Fine, thank you. And you?
And you?
But I need to go to the supermarket because I don't have milk. Milagro, you need anything else?
Please, I need to vegetables and fruit.
And you, Elizabeth?
I don't need nothing. But my mother have to boil chicken for dinner.
Okay, it's a pleasure.
Francisco, how much is it? I give you $20?
No, I need to give me $10.
Okay, perfect.
That's it.
Finished.
Nice, guys. Very good job. That was very nice. Very fluent, you know. I like the vocabulary that you use. Francisco, very good pronunciation. Elizabeth, good, you know, follow-up of activities. Good grammar as well. Milagro, nice. Very good attitude. That's super good. Milagro, I'm going to give you the privilege to select the next person.
Okay, thank you. Ahorita voy a seleccionar a Christian.
Okay, Christian, there you go. So that was Christian, Fatima, and Veronica?
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead, guys.
Hi, girls. How are you, Veronica?
I'm fine, thank you. How are you, Christian?
I'm fine. How are you, Fatima?
I'm fine. Thanks for asking.
Okay. I'm so good. Veronica, tell me, what do you need to do in your house?
I need to cook China food because today is the birthday month. I have to ready at 6 p.m. What about you? What do you need to do at work today?
I have a long day because I need send reports of the last month. Then I have to arrange a meeting with my boss. And finally, I need to go to Veronica's house at 6 p.m. And you, Kristen, what are you doing today?
Well, I have to check the employees at work. Next, I need to call some clients. And finally, me too, I go to the Veronica's house. Tenemos fiesta en la casa de Verón.
Invite us. We are from your cluster too. Nice job, everybody. Very good. I like the party thing. That is very nice. No, that was very good. And that was quite clear. Thank you, guys. Fatima, select next person.
Gerson.
Okay, Gerson, go ahead, please.
My group is Cesar, Sandra, no.
Yes.
Yes. Sandra and, por si me escapa alguien.
Perit and Silvia.
Edith and Silvia.
Oh.
Okay, Cesar, you begin or you start. Please.
Okay. Okay. Hello, everybody.
Hello, Cesar.
Hi, Cesar.
Hello. Hey, everybody. What do you need to do this weekend?
Cesar, I need to go to the beach because I need to live with my house. Oh, yes, my house, because the pandemic is very, very bad for me.
Yes, yes. I need to go to the beach. And you, Sandra?
I need to travel. And I need to sleep. and Silvia?
Oh, I need to pay my cell phone and I go to the shopping.
Where are you shopping?
Because I don't have it.
Okay. Well, I have to wash my car in this weekend because it's very dirty.
Really?
And I need a rest and watch a movie. I have a hard week.
Nice. And Sandra, do you wash your car in the weekend? At weekend? On weekend?
No. I go to the car wash. I don't like.
Only men wash the car.
Team men.
You need to go to the car wash.
Team men. And Edith, do you need to do the weekend?
No está Edith.
I don't see Edith.
She needs to go to the.
She needs to come back.
She needs to go to the bathroom.
No, she needs to come. Because she's not here, right? You're terrible being with her. Thank you, guys. Oh, very nice job. No, it's fine. Very nice job. That was very good. Very good conversation and very clear. I like the way you combined all the sentences. Super. Thank you. Thank you, Sandra, for the emoji. That was all right. Okay, Cesar, select next.
Andres.
Andrew, are you there, Andrew? Yes, there he is. So that was Andres. I think we got also Jennifer. Andres, Jennifer.
Jennifer, Ada, and Isaac.
Isaac, okay. Please go ahead.
Hi, guys.
Hi, Andres.
Good night.
Good night. Good evening.
Good evening.
How are you, Andres?
Hi, and you, Ada?
Hi.
I have to again. I have to do work.
Oh, I need to wake up at 5 o'clock. I need to take a shower. I need to go to the park at 6 o'clock. I go to the work at 7 o'clock. I need to, I have to check report, to check patient. I need to the salary preparation at 8 o'clock. After 12 o'clock, in the afternoon, I go to the clinic and 1 p.m. and take a break at 2 p.m. I go to, I have the to send emails. I come to the meeting at 3 or 4 o'clock. I go to the house at the 7 and 6 o'clock. I do 8 a.m. Class English. I need to.
I need in class. The English. Isaac, tell me. You have or need then your job.
Hello, I just reached the source, God, but I need in create this number. At what area do you need blue reports in your work? Andres.
Okay. Repeat, please.
I think his question is, okay, no, I think his question was, what area do you need to reinforce in your job? Is Isaac, was that your question?
Yes.
What area to reinforce? But what do you mean? Like about English? About like personal development? No, Isaac has lagging. Wait. Wait. Yes, Isaac? Lo que pasa es que tiene lagging, entonces se tarda un poquito más el internet.
Yep. Voice in word.
I don't know if it's me, guys, pero se escucha un poquito como cortado.
I don't understand.
Yes. Turn on the light.
Oh, okay. I don't understand the question.
Isaac, do me a big favor. Por un segundito, apague la cámara y probemos con eso. Puede ser que el internet le está dando issues. I mean, no deberíamos. We shouldn't be turning the camera on, pero probemos como, like, troubleshooting super quick.
Sí, le decía él que sobre el trabajo, sí. Que acaba de alcanzar lo que es la meta, pero que necesitaba aumentar ese número. Y luego le continuaba la conversación con... ¿Y tú qué necesitas reforzar en tu trabajo?
Ah, okay. Yeah, that was the part that I didn't get. Ah, okay. Okay, Andres, so you can, like, continue with that part.
Okay. I have that in my job, check emails that client. I need my coffee cup that, like, is ready. The send email, sell the client. That's the secretary and sales assistant. I am is all in. And tell me, Jen, what your job you have and need.
I have stay early in my job. I need to stay at 7 o'clock. And I need to send email. And I have do the inspections. And I have go to the meetings. And in the afternoon, I need do the report. But coming home at 5:30 p.m. and I need to stay in English class at 8 p.m.
Nice, very good.
That's it, teacher.
Okay, guys, thank you. Very nice job, and that was very clear. So I think we got exactly what you need to do. Very good. I think I'm missing one more group. I think I'm missing... Sandra's group? Yeah, Sandra Patricia, right? Oh, yeah. And you were like, teacher, forget it. I Yeah, you see. So we got Sandra, we got Doris, and we got Madeline. Yeah, where is Madeline? Oh, here she is.
Hi.
Okay. Okay. Hi, girls. Okay.
I will start. Hi, girls. How do you doing in your work?
I'm very tired because I have to organize plans to 2021. And you, Doris?
I have to arrange reports and meetings. And you, Madeline?
I feel good because I have a new work. And I have to arrive early because I need to send memos, emails, and reports.
Hey, girls, we need to go to the party on Friday.
Yes, it's a good idea. Where will be the party?
It's in my house. See you later.
Okay, bye-bye.
Okay, girls.
What time?
Ahí te voy a mandar la invitación.
Invitae.
Yeah, that was nice. That was very nice.
To parties tonight.
To parties tonight or Saturday. I didn't remember. But either way, that was very nice. I like that you were having parties, guys. That's very good. Okay, guys. Let me just go over a couple of things. Okay, so let's take a look at these words. We got clients, we got Wi-Fi, we have this word. We have this one. Oh my goodness, let me try to remember. Okay, so I think those are the ones that I paid attention to. So let's just repeat them, guys. Let me make this a little bit bigger. So let's repeat the first. The first is client.
Client.
The second one, guys, is Wi-Fi. Yeah. The next one is arrive. The next one is customer. Then we have organize. And the last one is
dish.
Yeah, very good.
I have a question.
Cesar, tell
me. What is the difference between client and customers?
Pretty much is the same. You can say client or you can say customer. But es como lo que usted usa. Normalmente usamos customer porque son como, I don't know, para no verlo como dinero. We simply use the word customer. But client is also okay. I mean, it's fine. But le recomendaría, I mean, si trabaja en el área de business, que tenga clientes, no usemos client, usemos customer. Vemos como persona. And the last one, guys, que se me olvidó, es live or live. Se pueden ambas, pero hay una pequeña diferencia. Si usted quiere decir el verbo de vivir. Yeah, if you want to say, for example, yo vivo en San Salvador, I live in San Salvador. I live in Santa Tecla. ¿Cuándo entonces yo voy a decir live? Any idea? Any volunteer?
In past. No.
Not really. En pasado le agregamos una D que lo van a ver en el siguiente módulo. Okay, but not really. Live. ¿Alguna vez han visto un partido de fútbol? Like a soccer match.
Yeah.
Life. Soccer matches,
yes.
Arriba dice la palabra live, ¿ya? Pero no se refiere a vivir, se refiere a en vivo. Yeah. Entonces, no se pronuncia live, se pronuncia live. So that
conciertos.
Is the difference. Exactly, concerts,
online.
Soccer matches. Entonces usted dice, oh, it's live. So cuando usted dice it's live, está en vivo. O Facebook live. Entonces sí se pronuncia live. Pero si yo digo, yo vivo, I live.
O live in English.
Exactly. Right now, this is a live class. So no live. Live es vivir. I live. Okay. Live es en vivo. So be careful with the pronunciation. Porque si se puede confundir, right?
I have a question.
But podemos decir, I live that last in life?
It depends what you want to say. It depends, Andrew. Madeline, what's your question?
¿Cómo se traduce? Yo no necesito nada.
I don't need anything.
Okay.
I don't need anything. Luego van a ver también las negaciones dobles. Creo que me pregunta por nothing, right? So.
Yes, porque lo escuché en alguno de los compañeros.
Yeah, normalmente si usted ya dijo I don't, entonces el otro no usó nothing, sino I don't need anything. I don't know anything. Luego lo vamos a ver. No worries. Con el tiempo you will identify this. Okay, everybody, tenemos 7 minutos. We got 7 minutes for the last activity. And this is just a correct. Check the correct sentences and correct the wrong sentences. Okay? So, we have a little reading here. Y vamos a ver cuáles están correctas. First, let's take a look at this reading. Let me read it for you. It says, hello, my name is John Wilson. I work in an office. I am a human resources manager. Madeline, please, can you continue?
Every day I check emails for the company. And I always answer the phone and talk to potential employees.
Thank you very much. Elizabeth, can you continue? Generally.
Me perdí un poco, teacher.
Acá, Elizabeth, generally.
Generally, I attend meeting in the morning and not so often in the afternoon.
Thank you. Thank you. That's okay. Francisco, can you continue? In my company.
In my company, we always have events. We have to attend a conference on June 21, and then we have a meeting about the conference
on July.
July 22 a.m. Always busy.
Okay, thank you very much, Francisco. So everybody, let's take a look at this reading that we have. First of all, ¿cuáles son verdad? Which of them are correct? His name is John Wilkins. Is this correct or is this incorrect? So help me please with incorrect. The first.
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Incorrect. What is his name?
His name is John Wilson.
John Wilson.
John Wilson. Very good. That's John Wilson. Number two, he writes reports every day.
Correct. Incorrect.
Incorrect?
Incorrect.
What is the what is the correct answer?
I check emails.
Email.
He checks emails.
I always answer the phone.
Uh-huh. So he checks emails, exactly. He doesn't write reports. Very good. Number three. He never answers the phone and talks to customers.
Incorrect.
Incorrect.
What is the correct sentence?
I always answer the phone and talk to potential employees.
Very good. So talk to a potential employees, exactly. Number four, he often attends meetings in the morning.
Correct.
Correct.
Correct. Yeah, exactly. This is correct. Number six. He usually has events in the company.
Incorrect.
Incorrect. What is the correct answer?
He always has events.
Le faltó la número cinco, teacher.
Teacher and five.
Oh, sorry. He never, exactly. Okay. Sí, me salté una. Number five. He never attends meetings in the afternoon.
Incorrect. And not so often in the afternoon.
Incorrect, because this is said never.
In the morning.
In the morning.
Correct. Correct.
Revisemos, okay, revisemos la número 4 nuevamente. He often attends meetings in the morning. Si se fijan acá, if you pay attention, dice que I attend meetings, right? So puede ser que fine, yeah? Now, what about number 5? He never attends meeting in the afternoon. Correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
Correct. Okay, ¿cómo la cambiaríamos? How can we change it?
I often attend.
Porque dice acá, and not so often, not so often. Not so often in the afternoon. Pero acá dice, he never. Entonces, ¿cuál podemos encontrar? ¿Cuál palabra me indica lo mismo que not so often?
Hardly ever.
Oh, hardly ever. Exactly, hardly ever. ¿Otra palabra que podemos utilizar?
Almost always.
Almost always sería como lo opuesto. Because here
almost he said, ever.
Hardly ever. Esa es la que nos mencionaba Madeline. ¿Puede haber otra? Yes.
Seldom.
Seldom. Rarely. Exactly. Exactly. Very good. Number 6. He usually has events in his company. True or false? Correct or incorrect?
Incorrect.
Incorrect. So what is the correct answer?
He always have events.
Exactly. He always. Very good. Y la última de las, when he has to go to the conference on July the 22nd, true or false?
Incorrect.
Incorrect. Number 7?
Incorrect.
What is the correct answer?
Correct is on July 23rd.
Cesar?
The correct is he has to go to a conference on July 21st.
On July 21st.
21st.
July 21st. Okay, so let's take a look at this. Dice, we have to attend a conference on July 21st. And then we have to attend a meeting about the conference. Ah, very good point. Esta dice, he has to go to the conference. Pero la conference no es on July. Yes, these are very good. La conference is July 21st. Nice, very good point. So he has to go to the conference on July 21st. Exactly, July 21st. So it is incorrect. Very good. Nice reading. Nice reading skills. Okay, everybody. So, pretty much this is part of the reading that we have for today. My goodness, time is over. Okay, solo les robo un minutito rapidito. Les quiero mostrar, si todavía no me han encontrado, a dónde está la discusión. I'm gonna show it like super, super quick. Permítame. Permítame, hold on, guys, give me just a quick second here. Okay, solo les muestro rapidito. Chicos, hasta el momento nosotros tendríamos que estar trabajando en la sesión del día de ahora, que es need to, how to use have to I need to, que es esta conferencia, la conferencia número 8. Number 8, all right? So, ustedes ven, por ejemplo, la conferencia número 7, a ustedes les aparece como el videíto de nuestra clase, pero la tarea, recordemos que es de carácter diario. No les aparece como foro, sino como tarea. Entonces, usted se va a la parte de discusión. Ok, so, uy, ahí estoy. So, you go to the part of the discussion que está acá, all right? Deme un segundito. So, ahorita carga. Y en la parte de discusión, a usted le aparece sesión 1, sesión 2, sesión 3, etc. So, voy a seleccionar acá todos los temas. Y si se fijan, no me quiere cargar. Ok, acá están. Por ejemplo, la sección número uno dice self-introduction, introduce yourself. Entonces todos nos vamos a presentar, decimos información personal, right? Sesión, por ejemplo, por alguna razón se desordenó. But, por ejemplo, la número tres está por acá, dice how many and how much. Entonces respondemos las preguntas. La número cuatro, write five things you don't like. La número cinco, write a short description of your... write a short description of your friends and family using simple present tense, porque esta sesión trabajamos con tercera persona. La número 6, por ejemplo, how often. Entonces acá hay preguntas y ustedes van a responder. Dice acá, por ejemplo, el de Sandra. Yay, Sandra llevó el suyo. El de Sandra dice, how often do you brush my hair? I rarely, y con la respuesta, I rarely brush my hair. Okay. So, si se fijan, esto es como la tarea diaria, right? No les aparece tanto como un foro, sino como una tarea de carácter diario. Así que si todavía no hemos entrado a esa parte de discusión, porque 9 me falta casi la mitad, por ejemplo, en la parte 1, ayúdenme a completarlo, por favor. Help me a lot with this. Y igual, si yo veo como algo en lo que podamos trabajar, yo le voy a comentar, revisen este tema, revisen el otro. Y así les vamos dando seguimiento también para que no nos queden vacíos. ¿Preguntas? Do you have any questions with this?
Yes.
Yes, tell me.
Teacher, ¿hasta cuál sesión tendríamos que tener actualizado hoy, digamos?
Les voy a actualizar la de... En teoría está todos los días, ¿verdad? La 1, 2, 3, 4.
¿Ahora qué número es?
La última que les aparece es la número 6, si no me equivoco, ya les actualizo la de ayer y la de ahora.
Dicha, pero esas no son las homework, ¿verdad?
No, miss, esas son las discusiones. Es como para consolidar, es una por cada uno de los temas. E igual ustedes pueden comentarle al compañero y pueden ver lo que ellos han escrito. Porque la tarea es a veces como bien cerradita y solamente está la oportunidad de cliquear la respuesta correcta. En cambio, esto les da la oportunidad de ser más creativos, incrementar vocabulario as well. All right. So, me ayudan con esa parte, guys. Thank you so much for your time. Les robé más de un minuto. Thank you so much. I'll be seeing you tomorrow. And have a good rest of your night. Bye-bye, everyone.
Bye-bye.
Good night.
Bye-bye.
Good night. Good night, everyone. See you tomorrow.